Hi, this is Andrei Osachuk. I welcome you to another training on Adobe Analytics Analysis Workspace. And today I want to show you one of the methods that you may want to use for target achievement visualization. Before we start, just a few words about why you may want to use target achievement in your dashboards. This is one of the primary KPIs for every business. For every month, every quarter, every year, you should have a target. The target can be broken down into different segments. For example, you may have target for traffic, but you also can have a target for traffic by marketing channel. You may have a target for sales volume. Sales volume can be broken down into different product categories. Similar for leads, submissions, etc. This is why target achievement is one of the primary components in a variety of different projects and dashboards. So how to do this? Usually, first what you need to make sure is that targets are available for you in Adobe Analytics. This is a big topic and I won't cover how to get targets available in Adobe Analytics. Today I just want to focus on how to visualize the performance. What we can see on the screen is just this very simplistic way how you can visualize the target achievement. The first chart shows you the actual targets that were set for a certain reporting period. In my case, this is last month. And the second chart shows whether we achieved or didn't achieve the target KPI for marketing channels. And underneath, we have another visualization that basically the source of these charts, and we can see the targets and target achievements. What I want to show you today is another method that I would consider a better way, and let's have a look at it. On the left, we have targets and actuals. So for example, I can quickly understand where we achieved or didn't achieve the target. For example, here for the email marketing, we can see that the target is higher than the actual performance, and this is why we didn't achieve the target. Or vice versa, for the print channel, we can see that we actually overperformed our target numbers. But in addition to that, I can also see whether we showed a positive lift in our KPI. For example, despite the fact that for some marketing channels, we didn't reach the target numbers, we can recognize that for every channel, we have a positive growth. For this purpose, I can just compare green and blue bars. In addition to that, to make it easier to work with, I can always hide one of the bars, which will give me even better visualization for the question whether we grew or didn't grow. And finally, if you want to compare just target achievement, we can hide the 2 months ago actual. The other two visualizations on the right tell me whether we achieved or underachieved the target. So basically, it's very simple to understand which channels underperformed. I just need to recognize the purple bars, and those bars show me by how much the target wasn't achieved. And the blue bars indicate those channels where we have overachievement, the achievement higher than 100%. So this is a very convenient way, because I just can recognize where the problem is or with which channels, which dimension elements or segments we had, let's say, a problem. And afterwards, I can focus on an analysis and try to understand the causing factors. And obviously, on the bottom, there is a table. The table can be used with the charts or without the charts as a standalone visualization. And it shows us the actuals. And it's good because we can actually read all the numbers. We don't need to hover the mouse cursor over different bars. We can quickly recognize the actual performance. We can have a look at the target achievement column. Thanks to different colors, we can quickly recognize where we underachieved or achieved the target numbers. If you want to learn how to build such visualizations, you're very welcome to enroll in my Adobe Analytics Analysis Workspace Mastery course. If you have questions, please leave them in the comments under this video. Thank you for watching.